Spencer plays it in front. Brassard scores.
Last year's magical run in the playoffs will emanate through the minds of Senators fans forever. But with a long run, a price has to be paid. Senators forward Derek Brassard played through a torn labrum during the playoffs and needed right shoulder surgery in the offseason.
Pretty frustrated. I've been in that situation before in New York, and it's really hard to win in this league. And every time you have a chance or you have a crack, you kind of have to take the opportunity. It's just basically three quarters of our team was banged up, and that's just the way it is. That's just the way that it is at that time of the year. And you kind of have to battle through and not think about it.
Acquired in the summer of 2016 from the New York Rangers, that also saw Mika Zibanejad go the other way, Derek Brassard was now lacing up the skates for his hometown team, a feat that is hard to do in any league, but especially the NHL.
Last year was pretty special for me. It took me a couple weeks, or I'd say a couple months, to get adjusted to the new team and the way we're playing the game. And that run was so much fun. I knew how good of a team they had before, but I didn't know how good we actually were. And we have a lot of good players here. We have good chemistry. And I think the way we play the game, we can be really annoying to play against. And I think the structure that we had defensively last year was great. But I think this year, offensively, we can find a way to be more creative, I think. And we have a lot of offensive skill up front. So I think we... offensively, I think we can improve a little bit.
With a new team comes new tactics and systems. Flying high on Broadway were the Rangers with their offensive speed and skill, but here in Ottawa, a completely different playing style would be welcome in 2017. The head coach Guy Boucher and his defensive mindset, something Brassard and the Sens had to buy into.
It's pretty unique the way we play here, and I think we proved to ourselves, to everyone in the league, that it works. Yes, it was a big adjustment for me personally. In New York, it was more a run and gun kind of offense, and Alain Vigneault, coach, was pretty aware of the defensive side of it as well. But I think offensively, he was just kind of letting us express ourselves here. It's a lot more structure in our game, and offensively, it's pretty much the same way. So. It's an adjustment for everyone, I think you have to let your ego on the side and kind of just be part of the team and try to put your best foot forward to win some hockey games.
The big talk of the offseason was the Las Vegas Golden Knights being the newest franchise in the NHL. With the expansion draft, the Senators lost defenseman Mark Methot, but Brassard lost a good friend as well. They both played together for five seasons with the Columbus Blue Jackets and Syracuse Crunch of the American Hockey League, forming a great bond with each other.
It's pretty hard. I played with Mark for 6 or 7 years. We started the minors together, and just the way he plays the game is 6'3", whatever he is, 230, 240 pounds defensemen. They're pretty hard to find in this league, and the way he moves, his presence is obviously big, and we were pretty disappointed to lose him, especially in the room. He's got a pretty funny, just a good all-around guy. And it is what it is. We have some really good young prospect coming up. We signed Johnny Duja, two-time Stanley Cup champion. Freddie Claesson played really well last year in the playoffs, and there's a lot of guys that can step up, so I'm not worried for that.
Just like the weather, Derek Brassard and the Senators look to turn the cold they're feeling right now into something much hotter as spring approaches. With the second half of the season ticking away day by day, Ottawa looks to see what the Sens can do down the final stretch. For Ottawa Senators Overtime, I'm Tyler McDonald.